at all times. And because God is in control at all times, all the time, that when things do happen in our lives, when blessings do come, sometimes it's like, God, why now?
Wow.
How come you didn't bless me like this yesterday? Or you know what? I could have really used this last week. And a lot of times God doesn't tell us why he does what he does when he doesn't. But I've given this a lot of thought. Why does God do whatever God does when God doesn't? And there could be many answers to this, and I've given this a great deal of thought. And I've come down to one reason. In Galatians chapter 4, the Bible says this. But when the fullness of time had come, God sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, that we might receive the adoption as sons. In this verse alone, we find out what God does. The Bible says in Galatians 4, God sent forth his son. He sent forth his son, born of a woman. He sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law. And then the verse goes on and tells us why God sent his son. To redeem those who were under the law, that we might receive the adoption as sons. But then within this verse, I've also come to see that not only does God tell us what he does and why he does it, but then God told us the secret on why God does whatever God does when God does it. It's written right here in verse 4, Galatians 4. But when the fullness of time had come. This is what God is about. This is the reason why God does whatever God does when God does it. You want to know why? Because it's about time. As we look in Matthew chapter 26, the Lord shows us how Jesus was sensitive to time. And of course, because Jesus is our guide, Jesus is our teacher, we're to learn from him and be just as sensitive to God's time. Everyone say this, it's about time. As we participate in the Lord's table this morning, we're to be reminded of God's time. This morning's sermon is entitled, It's About Time. Let's pray. Father, thank you for the next few moments. We have the opportunity to sit at your table and to dine on your word. You said that your word is health and that it's strength. So, Lord, bring health and strength into our bodies, mm-hmm. into our spiritual bodies, so that we can come to know you all more. So, Lord, be glorified and be honored over the next few moments. In Jesus' holy name, Lord, to God alone be the glory. Amen.